Web and HTML elements. Throughout this lesson, you'll hear us referring to web and HTML elements. A web or HTML element can be almost anything on a web page. They are what give web pages their structure. Some of these elements you will be able to interact with using JAWS, like edit boxes, which allow you to enter text, or combo boxes, which allow you to make a selection. Others, like still graphics, won't allow you to interact with them as much. We have updated and revised our Surfs Up, Surfing the Internet with JAWS training, and we are going to take a quick peek at the web elements section we added to that. Let's go look. Our focus is now on the web elements lesson on Surfs Up. Let's take a peek and see what JAWS has to say is here.
Elements are used to create the structure of a web page and are used to present information in various ways. JAWS interacts with these elements to provide the information you need to access the page contents. Some of the most common web page elements you will encounter include colon, bullet links, bullet paragraphs, bullet headings, bullet numbered and bulleted lists, bullet tables, bullet regions, bullet images, bullet form controls including radio buttons, edit fields, checkboxes, combo boxes, list boxes, and buttons.
JAWS has listed you some web elements there, and we're not going to go into too much detail about what each of those are and how to interact with each one, as that's a lesson to itself. We're going to focus on just the concept of web elements. Continue down this page, you will find a lot more information about web elements, like the quick nav information that Elizabeth will cover with you on navigating the internet, as well as information and keyboard commands for how to list different elements on a web page. And that's what I'd like to talk about for just a moment now. We have moved our focus once again, and we are now at freedomscientific.com/training. I will demo for you several of the keyboard commands you can use within JAWS to list web or HTML elements on a web page. We'll start with Insert F3 or JAWS key F3. I'll do it now.
Virtual HTML features dialog, list one list view, anchors list, 1 of 21.
I've opened a dialog with Insert F3 that lists several different HTML or web elements that can appear on a page. I can use the up and down arrows to navigate.
Articles list, block quotes list, buttons list, checkboxes list, lists list, paragraphs list.
And you've heard a number of different types of web or HTML elements that could possibly be on a page. When I reach the one I'd like, I'm going to go ahead and press enter. What's happened is the previous dialog box closed and a new one opened. And what's listed in this dialog box are all of the paragraphs that are marked on this page as web elements. I'm going to use the down arrow to browse through
them. Fusion training resources. The JAWS Registered Sign Training page is your one-stop source for finding free training materials in a variety of formats and on a range of topics. Surfs Up Internet Navigation Training is now on the JAWS Training Resources page.
And you'll see that each of those paragraphs that is marked, JAWS will read the first line, which appears in this dialog. I'll press Escape now. Two other commands that are very handy for listing web elements on a page are Insert F6 or JAWS key F6 and Insert F7 or JAWS key F7. Insert F6 lists all the headings on a page, whereas Insert F7 lists the links on a page. I'll demo Insert F6 now.
Heading list dialog, headings list view, training and certification :1, 1 of 10.
Again, I can down arrow through this for
Fusion
navigation.
Training resources :2.
And you'll hear the different heading levels
JAWS
mentioned.
JAWS training resources :2. Zoom text training resources :2.
I'll press Escape now.
Escape.
It's a handy way to jump through a page with many, many headings. And now we'll look at Insert F7. I'll press that now.
Links list dialog. Links list view. JAWS training resources. 14 of 39.
The links list is an extremely valuable tool when you're browsing the internet, as there can be so many possible links on one page. This compiles them all together in one dialog box that you can navigate with first letter navigation or the arrow keys. I'll press home to make sure I'm at the top
home
of the links list.
Freedom Scientific.
And the first link in this list is the Freedom Scientific homepage. I'll press enter to activate it. I mentioned insert F3 to list all of the web elements possibly on a page, as well as insert F6 to list headings, insert F7 to list links. And there's one more that I don't use as often, but you can also use insert F5 to list all the form fields on a page. This can be extremely useful if you're filling out a page with a lot of edit fields.
Freedom Scientific, of the Sparrow brand. If you are interested in other training, please visit us on the web at freedomscientific.com/training and on YouTube on our Freedom Scientific training channel.